In this video, we're going to talk about how we find the derivative of a polar curve, and how we find the slope. Now, a couple of things you just need to really be careful and remember all the time are really these, that x is equal to r cosine theta, and that y is equal to r sine theta. Those things are so important and will help you so much in solving these problems. So, let me start by writing in our case what x and y are. So I'm just going to do that right down here. Remember that x is equal to r cosine theta. Well, for us, r is 4 cosine theta. So I'm going to do a little substitution. Okay, I'm going to have 4 cosine theta multiplied by cosine theta. Okay, now just make sure you see that. I just replaced r with what r was equal to. So r cosine theta. Okay? So y is r sine theta. Okay? So now I know what x and y are equal to. Well, let me right off to the side here. I want to know what dy dx is. And the easiest way to do that is to say, well, what, because notice that both x and y right now are in terms of theta. Theta is the variable for both x and y. So why wouldn't I find the derivative of y with respect to theta and the derivative of x with respect to theta, and I could divide those. And remember, dividing fractions is the same as multiplying by the reciprocal. And take a look at what happens. The d thetas cancel, and I get dy dx. So I'm going to just find the derivative of y with respect to theta and divide it by the derivative of x with respect to theta. Now, this can get a little bit tedious, and you'll see that the reason is because it's going to require product rule. Finding the derivative, I'm going to have a first and a second. I'm going to have to do product rule, and I'm going to have to do it twice. I'm going to have to do it both to find the derivative of y and the derivative of x. So these things end up being, you know, pretty big. They're a pretty big equation. So let's start with dy. Okay. So I've got the first multiplied by derivative of the second. The derivative of sine is cosine. Plus the second multiplied by derivative of the first. And the derivative of 4 cosine theta is negative 4 sine theta. Like that. And then I have to do the same type of thing with x. First multiplied by derivative of the second plus the second multiplied by derivative of the first. Now what I would do is plug in pi over 3. So I'd have, you know, I'd plug that in for every single spot, 4 times the cosine of pi over 3 multiplied by the cosine of pi over 3 plus the sine of pi over 3 times negative 4 times the sine of pi over 3 and so on. And I'm going to rely on the fact that you could do that either, you know, you could do it by hand or that you could do it on your calculator. I'm not going to plug that in. But this is how you would find the slope at pi over 3. Now in this next example, it says find the slope at the indicated point. And what's a little bit tricky here, it will maybe become evident in a little bit, but let's start with the fact that, again, x is r cosine theta. So for us, that means it's 2 sine theta plus 1 cosine theta. And remember, we're just substituting what r is equal to. So y is r sine theta, which for us is 2 sine theta. Oh, I forgot the plus 1. Sine theta. Let's do that. Okay, so we're going to find our dy dx. So we're going to do the derivative of y, the first, multiplied by derivative of the second, plus the second, multiplied by derivative of the first. Okay. For x, we'll do first times derivative of the second, plus the second times derivative of the first. You'll sometimes hear people say to memorize this type of thing. I don't think that that's useful. I think that if you know product rule, this is just one of those things you don't need to memorize. If you just remember your product rule and remember that x is equal to this and y is equal to that, you're going to be fine. Now, maybe you see what the problem is. The problem at this point is that we don't know what the angle is. We don't know what theta is. They told us that point, but they didn't tell us what to plug in for theta. So here's what we need to do, and this is good practice for finding areas, which is what we're going to do next. We need to say, well, what angle would put us at the origin like this? Well, remember, the origin is where r is equal to 0, because remember, r tells us how far from the origin we are. R of 2 means we go out 2 units, and r of 5 means we go out 5 units. So an r of 0 means we're right at the origin. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the original equation, let me put it right here, 2 sine theta plus 1, and I'm going to say, well, that's r, and I need to know when that's 0. So I'm going to subtract 1 from both sides. I'm going to divide by 2. And I need to figure out when sine is negative 1/2. Well, sine is 1/2 at pi over 6 and 5 pi over 6. So sine is negative 1/2 at 7 pi over 6 and 11 pi over 6. And if this seems a little strange to you, I want you to remember, let me do that. At that point, we actually do have two slopes. Right? It's actually crossing at both things. So now, again, in the interest of time, I'm going to rely on the fact that you could plug this in. Okay? If you need help doing that, check with me or watch a video that does that. But you would plug the two in. You'd plug in 7 pi over 6 and get one slope. You'd plug 11 pi over 6 in and get the other slope. You'd be able to do that either, you know, by hand or with the calculator. But make sure you can do that. And if you don't remember that, you might want to go back and relearn some of your trig, maybe look back at the hand trick for the trig, the unit circle, the trig values, but I'm not going to finish that off. So just be careful. Always remember r cosine theta and r sine theta are your x and y coordinates respectively. Use product rule to get your derivative, and in this case, of course, the little added wrinkle was you did not know what theta was, but we were able to solve for it. We knew that r was 0 because we were at the origin. So we said, well, okay, well, you know, let's just solve when the function is equal to that. You know, if we'd said something like, yeah, but what's the slope here? Then, of course, r is 1 because you're 1 unit away from the origin. You would have set it equal to 1 and solved it. So there are a number of problems and things you could do with this.